This is a phenomenon that has primarily grown in America through the corporate takeover of American radio. And basically some people came up with the term, sort of use it as a phrase to describe, you know, what really is like R&B music more than anything. But I actually, being the jazz liberal that I am, would include Kenny G in the jazz category. I feel like he deserves to be in the jazz bin, as does Grover Washington and all those guys. And I actually don't feel like those people should be exempt from comparisons to John Coltrane. They're playing the same instrument. They're trying to improvise. And it's clear that the standard that was set by John Coltrane is a much higher one. And that's obvious in the music itself. And the standard that I aspire to is the highest standard that I can imagine. And all of the music that I've tried to play has been music that has honestly and respectfully attempted to be the best kind of music that it can be for what it is. Yes, it's true. There are those stations that play three songs of mine, usually cutting out the pesky improvised section, keeping only the, you know, nice melodies that I guess I am capable of coming up with. You know, in the body of the work that I've recorded over the years, let's say 99.5% of it is unrepresented in that, in those stations, by those stations. So, I mean, I don't really have a strong relationship with that world. On the other hand, like every other musician playing the kind of music that we're roughly talking about here, survival is an issue for me. And I mean, any opportunity that we get to bring new people to our music, we kind of need it. And if those three songs with the pesky solo cut out bring in a few thousand new listeners to our music, which honestly they do, I have to acknowledge that as a source of survival for us. Doesn't really damage our thing too much. It pretty much functions on its own anyway. Mm-hmm.